the couple could turn their attentions to making the building look, well, enchanting. Helping them achieve that was Josephine, who's been working with Maggie on the many murals and, of course, her paintings.
Three originals, quite a few limited edition prints, because we bought one lot and then realised there's room for a whole lot more. So we really enjoyed all that, deciding which rooms were going to have which, and making up all the titles of the rooms to go with all the different romantic images.
Josephine has been really our inspiration. So, in actual fact, her input has been so much in every aspect, even down to the light switch covers, which we've got her paintings on.
Josephine's thrilled to be involved. She says that displaying her art in an environment like this is better than any art gallery.
It's absolutely beautiful. I can't get over it. I couldn't have wished for them to have been a better place.
Josephine hasn't been the only one waving her magic wand to create the right atmosphere. The soft furnishings had to be perfect, and the lady tasked with that mammoth job was curtain maker Marlene.
Spent hours and hours and hours on this project. There's about 25 to 30 pairs of curtains, somewhere around about 40 swags. There's about 9 for each bed. Various tie-backs and blinds and little bits and pieces. The small things are what take the time quite often. There's a lot of work, a lot of hours.
And a lot of money. Maggie and Rick have created this enchanted building from almost nothing, and they're not finished yet. But is their budget a work of fantasy or fact?
Without the top floor done, I'd say it'd be around a couple of hundred thousand is what we would have spent. And obviously moving on to the top level is going to be a lot more money involved.
And also we're going to do the spa and the gym and the gardens, and then it's never ending. And then the Hansel and Gretel cottage, which would be in the future, hopefully.
It's been a tale fit for Aesop's fables and at times the Brothers Grimm. But after spending £750,000 buying it and almost £300,000 on renovations, will Rick and Maggie's enchanted manor cast a spell over two local estate agents?
There's lots of things that works well. In particular, the conservatory, which I think is a very pleasant room. Where it's got lots of glass, it's hopefully be nice and light and bright on sunny days, and a lovely place to dine.
Well, what's unusual for the Enchanted Manor is the size of the rooms that they're offering guests. The size of the rooms that you have, you would normally find in a much larger hotel, and probably the executive suites.
I'm sure that people from the mainland will find it very appealing.
I'm sure they will, but once the hotel is open for business, is it going to be worth magic beans or pounds sterling?
I wouldn't be surprised if it would fetch for something significantly in excess of £1 million.
I think the hotel would be worth something in the region of 1.2 million once it's up and running.
Taking into account how much they've spent buying and renovating this hotel, they've almost broken even. So are they pleased?
We bought more or less a business. And although it wasn't a successful one, what we've done here is we've created a wonderful home for ourselves, plus we've created something completely new that won't be seen anywhere, and particularly the island. So that's another business side of it, which I think over a couple of years is going to obviously increase its value again.
Yeah. Well, even now, we're getting so many inquiries. We've only just got the website up and the signs, and all the time we're getting so much interest, and people just want to stay here already.
With the opening fairy ball only weeks away, the couple are already getting into the swing of things. Maggie and Rick have sprinkled fairy dust over this property, and I wish them both a magical future.
New Brighton on the Wirral, just across the River Mersey from Liverpool. And it was here where recent property developers Arthur and June courted. So when they bought this three-storey Victorian townhouse at auction for £150,000, it gave them a chance to revisit. They were seeking something more for their retirement fund, so the two planned to turn the house into two self-contained flats and sell for profit. 7 months on, I returned expecting some big changes.
What's changed is the planning and the total layout, really. Originally, we were having a staircase to come up the back of the house and into, actually, the room we're in now, which will be a kitchen, with a doorway to the side of us here. The council, in their wisdom, decided they didn't like that, so we've had to redesign the whole thing. Access has to be within the building, so therefore we've now had to put a new doorway, a new entrance into the side street, and rehash the layout. We've got a second staircase to go in. There's some major differences have come about with the planning. What a shame.
Nothing seems to be going right. With planning refused, the couple could do nothing but redesign, resubmit, and then wait. Right. After several long months, they finally got the plans approved with a few changes made to the layout of the ground floor.
These are the approved plans, I'm glad to say. This is where the major changes are taking place. The new entrance to the ground floor masonette is here. This fireplace, unfortunately, is going to have to come out. The new doorway is going to be into this quarter here with a small cloakroom and wall here. There'll be a window in this section here just to bring some more light into this room, and this will be the dining area.
I hate to see period features go, but I hope this fireplace will find a home somewhere else. That must be the least of Arthur and June's problems. Their first project was building 8 terraced houses, so surely this was a breeze. In fact, they'd hoped to have it all finished in less than 4 months.
That's the way it goes, isn't it?
We're not in a, we've bought the house, so we're not in a position where there's a mortgage outstanding where some builders might be incurring some big expenses by not proceeding with the work. We'll just do it when it comes along.
Having said all of that, Arthur is supposed to have retired and intended to spend more time with June. So do all these delays mean that has worked out?
We have spent some more time together, yeah, we have.
Yeah. Been on holiday.
which has been part of the overall plan anyway.
Yeah.
When I retired from full-time work, the idea was that we would spend some more time together. Yeah, it's working out fine.
Yeah.
Because Arthur and June paid for this house outright, thankfully they haven't had to pay extra mortgage repayments due to the delay. But do the new plans mean more money on renovations?
The original budget was around £30,000, £25,000 to £30,000. With the changes in the building itself, that's now gone up to over £40,000, maybe £45,000. So it's been quite a significant change. What a shame.
Well, a shame it might be, but hopefully there's still a profit to be made, provided they stick closely to their budget. 7 months ago, they bought this house for £150,000, and now it's going to cost them £40,000 to convert into 2 flats. But will the changes to the plans affect the sale price? Time to ask 2 local estate agents.
I preferred the original plan with the fire escape to the side, but obviously due to complaints from the neighbours, it's had to be altered slightly. The side entrance, not a great fan of side entrances because it's directly onto the pavement, and I don't think it's an ideal situation.
As rare as it may seem, I'm in agreement with the planning authority there. I think the new arrangement is far better. Access off the main footway is obviously preferred always for owner-occupiers or tenants.
Well, they disagree about the plan, but will they agree on how much each flat will sell for once finished?
For the lower apartment, then, on 3 bedrooms, I would think in the region of about £145,000. For the upper 2-bedroom apartment, again, depending how it's finished, probably £130,000, £135,000.
Resale masonettes individually, ground floor, probably £135,000. The upper masonette, a little bit less, I would say perhaps £127,000, £125,000.
With those valuations taken into account, a large amount of money we're going to have to spend on the property. We're looking to be making about £60,000-£65,000.
That's certainly a good reward for all their patience. So, once this one's all finished, what next?
Oh, the future. I think we plan to buy a few more properties in between holidaying and enjoying ourselves.
Sounds like a good idea to me.
We've got lots more properties to tempt you with next time.
So join us then.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Caring for a premature baby in need of a crucial heart operation, BBC One Northern Ireland spends 10 days in May with the Blackpool Medics. That's a brand new series starting tonight at 7:30. We have a news update next, and then it's on to buy or not to buy.